Welcome back to Tenorshare, everyone. Have you guys ever met the problem that your iPhone suddenly stuck on black screen for no reason? No matter how you try it, it just won't go back to normal state. So I go to check it out, and I find out 3 ways to fix iPad black screen issue without data loss. Let's go. First, you need to make sure your iPad black screen issue is not caused by a hardware issue. If your iPad black screen appears after you drop it to the floor, then you should go to Apple Store for repair. Method 1. Repair iPad black screen with ReiBoot, no data loss. Because iPad black screen is most likely caused by iPad OS system went wrong, so I recommend you guys try repair system. This is an iOS device repair too. It can fix more than 150 iOS system issue. Also can repair iPad black screen issue. Check the download link in the description if you are interested. Once installed, connect your iPad to your PC or Mac, and then open ReiBoot. Click the green Start button. Choose Standard Repair. Here will require download firmware to fix your iPad. Click Download. The download won't be long, depending on your network condition. Once download is OK, click Start Standard Repair option. ReiBoot will start to repair your iPad. This will take a while, be patient, and relax. It will be done soon. Then you can see, my iPad is back to home page. I can access my iPad without any problem, and all my data are still there. Go try it. If you prefer to try some simple method first, follow next method. Method 2, force restart to fix iPad black screen. To force restart iPad, or iPad with a home button, press and hold both power button and home button. Keep holding till the Apple logo shows up. For iPad without a home button, press the volume up and press the volume down, and then press and hold the power button. Keep holding till the Apple logo shows up. Then you can check if the iPad is normal or not. If it goes back to black screen state, you can follow method 1 or 3 to fix it. Method 3. Update iPad with iTunes or Finder. Open iTunes or Finder and connect your iPad to it. Then here we need to put iPad in recovery mode. For iPad with a home button, press and hold both power button and home button. Keep holding till the recovery mode screen shows up. For iPad without a home button, press the volume up and press the volume down, and then press and hold the power button. Keep holding till the recovery mode screen shows up. Then you should see iTunes or Finder pop up a window. Choose Update here. iTunes or Finder will begin to download firmware. Once the firmware is okay, it will start to update your iPad. It will take a long time. You need to be patient. Now you can see my iPad is back to the normal state. But it is not working every time. So I recommend method 1. Okay, that's it. Hope this video is helpful to you. I will be grateful if you subscribe. See you guys next time.